Wonderful. See, now this is, you have, I would have shared the same inputs with you when it comes to posting your YouTube video or any social media post. I would have shared the same points what you both have come across without even me giving you any feedback. So these are the tips we thought of, that today we will be discussing how we can make our YouTube videos more attractive so that there are more views to it. People spend time in watching those videos. You have given it all. Your answers, your feedback makes a lot of sense. So let us come to the takeaway points of how our video should look like when we are posting it on any social media channel. Taking points from Nisha, as she spoke about the body language. Our body language talks a lot about while talking to people in general, when we are sitting in a meeting, when we are interacting with a group of people, be it your formal or informal ways of communication. Generally, an informal setup, be it your family sitting across for a tea or you are meeting your friends in a group, it doesn't matter how you're sitting, how you're talking, because people don't pay attention there. But whenever there's a formal meeting and you have a smart body language, like your back is erect, your shoulders are straight, your hair are combed, you are smiling, there's brightness, there's light makeup, that really counts. This is something which people might not compliment you all the time, but that comes to the eye of the person. Oh, she looks smart. Oh, he looks nice. So that's how your body language does many things. So it's a very, very rightly mentioned point by Nisha that I was seeing here and there, and I was playing with my microphone. So yeah, these are the good points to take away while recording a video, that my microphone is set, my camera is set, so that my focus is not on fixing the technologies or looking here and there. I am more towards the topic and I am synced in the topic to talk more. So good takeaway. And similar to that, what Sakshi said about the camera setting, it's very important. And you people have a better background than my background, I would say. Sakshi is always sitting in a place where there's a beautiful curtain behind. And that's how I was not able to trace that. Is it a recording or is it the real you that who's sitting and talking to us? Similarly, you are also having a good background, Nisha. A plain background always works. And I should implement the same since my table is here and it's more like an informal setup for me. That's why you could see a lot of things happening here. But it's always good that when you record, your background is clear backside, or it's beautiful, it's pretty, it's nicely done. That also attracts a lot to the viewers. Wow, that looks good, Choosing the right background, choosing the right camera setting. Your technological glitches are all aside when you are focusing in your YouTube channel or a YouTube video. And what more discussions happened? Like, what are the points that we discussed here? What was the body language, Nisha? What else did you pick up from your pointers?
Repetitions of words.
Yes, repetitions of word and thoughts coming up, and sometimes thoughts are not coming up, and hence we are looking here and there. It's natural, Nisha. So when something which comes up on the spot, it's not the speech that you were given in advance to prepare for 4 days and then come and execute it. It was not like that. You were given on the spot topics. So on the spot topics are like that, where you think and you answer. Looking here and there was not a fault. It can be like this if it is an impromptu something which is on the spot. Otherwise, if it is a speech, yeah, you know what you have to say. These are the thoughts. It's on paper. The bullet points are there that you can look on the paper and you can share. There you can say that, okay, having looking that side or that side or make a difference. Thinking about YouTube also. Now, if this is a YouTube video that you have to post, it's okay because it's an on the spot topic. That's okay. That's not a problem. So that is all right with you. Repetition of word happens because ideas are coming on the spot. So when the ideas are coming on the spot, there would be chances that you are repeating the same word, but that is also okay because naturally you will grow. Naturally, you will be better. As I'm seeing that you are being better than what you were 5, 6 sessions before, it's improving. So it will improve. It will continue to be better every next time when you'll be trying. And Sakshi's inputs were related to herself, that she said that she was stuck in the vocabulary many times and with the words many times. So Sakshi, not to critically evaluate yourself and not to compare yourself. So important point is that your journey, your competition is only with yourself. And when you see your own self, that how are you 10 sessions back, how were you 3 months back? And how are you now? You will not see any flaw there. You would see, wow, I'm being better. Wow, I'm still having words. Wow, I can communicate with people around only in English. So there is growth happening in your journey. But when we see that, oh, it's not there, it's not the way it is, I really have to work hard on me, on myself, is when I start comparing with people. Nisha ma'am is speaking so nicely. I'm not able to do it. Hell, I have to really work on myself. That's the problem. We don't have to compare. You will not be comparing yourself with Nisha. You are not comparing yourself with Richa. You are comparing yourself the previous you. How was Sakshi a month before? How is she now? If there is no improvement, yes, that's a learning that I am not improving for a month. I'm the same person. My speeches are same. My words where I'm stuck in is same. That's the problem. There we need to work. But through comparison, it will never work because there's always somebody who's better than us. So where would we go if we keep on comparing ourselves? Okay, so that's the takeaway. And regarding smile, which she mentioned, I think that's the key. That's the key that how and why people would look at you or people would want to watch you more is your personality, is your spark. And smile plays a very important role. Undoubtedly, Nisha, you have a beautiful smile.
Yes, ma'am. You
do have a beautiful smile. So she has rightly mentioned that your smile attracts people and they want to listen to you more. They want to see you more. So this is the first step. You know, like people, we say that the book should not be judged by its cover, but generally people judge you by how you are at the surface level. Later people get to know, okay, she has a beautiful heart. She's so kind. She's so intelligent. That's the later stage. Majority of the people that we come across, suppose you come across around 10,000 people every month through various ways, how like you interact on day-to-day basis, your students, students' parents, students' relatives, classmates, teammates, teammates' relatives, something, the chain goes on, and even social media, that people have seen your post, you have communicated. So suppose you count 10,000 people, you interact with 10,000 people every month. Now, when you're interacting with them, only 1% or maybe less than that 10, 20 people would be the one who would be knowing Nisha by heart, who would be knowing Sakshi by heart, to whom it doesn't matter how Sakshi looks, how Nisha looks, how she carries herself, because they know the heart. But majority, 99% people just know you on the surface. And if your surface is nice, they will get deeper. Oh, let me talk to her more. Let me know more about her. And that is how the inner comes later. First, it's the surface. If our surface is beautiful, people will go on more to know us better. So that's right. And what is the surface? Surface is not the face that we are gifted with, the body we are gifted with. Face is whatever we are gifted with, how beautifully we embrace it, how beautifully we respect it, how beautifully do I carry it? Imagining ourselves that